Hello, hello, Jennifer Klein here with Coldwell Banker, and it is my honor to be chatting with Jeff Sipes, the credit guru of Blue Water Credit. He has not only helped me personally with my credit, but he has also helped several of my clients, and he's just an all-around good dude. So welcome, Jeff. How's it going?
Hey, great. Yeah, we're making the best of the stay at home. Obviously, you guys can tell I don't have my fancy Zoom background of recording from my live from my bedroom.
Yeah. Hey, we got to do what we got to do.
Yeah. So thanks for having me.
Of course. Of course. So obviously we're having a lot of new information out into the environment. The biggest one I'm seeing is about forbearance. Obviously people making, not being able to make payments or in the future being concerned about not being able to make their payments. And so I had a lot of questions in regards to, how these things report. Like if you miss a credit payment because of forbearance, tell me about what that looks like from your end.
Sure. So the CARES Act that was signed March 27th made some changes to the Fair Credit Reporting Act. It's going to last till 4 months after this national emergency declaration ends. So we have a little bit of time on our hands for this. Under the CARES Act, as long as the account was current, up to date, there's a new word that they added to the Fair Credit Reporting Act. It's called accommodation. It's basically like a deal that you strike up with your with a creditor. And so my recommendation is if you've had job loss or if you've been challenged financially is to try to get a hold of your lender and work out some sort of payment arrangements. You can defer payments. Like you mentioned, Jen, forbearance. They're allowing sometimes partial payments, loan modification, and then basically ask them what your options are because there are a lot of options that the banks are willing to give you. And from a credit reporting standpoint, as long as you keep your end of the deal up, they're not going to report you delinquent even if you are missing payments. But the key with that is to try to make sure if I were you, I would take good notes, find out who you talk to, get their extension, their last name. If you can get something in writing from the bank or the creditor, that would be ideal. Mm-hmm. And then that way, if something down the road happens and you end up they end up showing late payments on your credit report, that you have something to fall back on to try to fight it.
Yeah, that's actually one thing that we did in our first interview was we wanted to reiterate that basically make sure whatever information you get it in writing, whether mm-hmm. it via email or jot down the notes after the fact, get a badge ID number, mark the time, yada, yada. This is something that I saw happen a lot during the short sale era before. People thought that they were in a modification because they talked to Susie on the phone who said, oh, sure, go ahead and make an $1,100 payment of a $1,500 payment. Go ahead, make whatever you can and we'll just accept it. And they thought that was a grant to a modification. Typically in a true modification, which may be a steamroll effect from a forbearance, you will have like a loan recast or something official in writing to modify that note. If you think about it, when you signed your mortgage, you were at a notary table in an escrow office, almost very legally binding yourself to that. So to make any amendments to that, you better have some pretty good black and white paperwork to back your play there, if you will.
Yeah, exactly.
And so the other thing that I remember too from when, forbearances first came in back before was like rolling 30-day lates and how is it 15 days and then you're late or is it 30 days and then you're late? Tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, so the good news about late payments is it's not going to show up on your credit report until you're actually 30 days late. So if your payment's due on the 20th of the month of April, and you aren't able to make it financially, you have 30 days to try to call your creditor and to work out some sort of, like I said, accommodation or deal, so that it doesn't show late when you are, May 20th comes around, then that's when the late payment will actually hit your credit. And, FICO is the score banks use for home loans. They also use them for credit card applications. FICO is the score that 90% of lending decisions are used. And so FICO says it's virtually impossible to predict the score, but here are some estimates. on what a 30-day late payment would do if your score was 740. And one 30-day late payment can impact the score 40 to 110 points. So if you're a 740, it could literally knock you down to a 640 by missing one payment on one account. So it's pretty significant, especially since lending is getting harder to get a loan these days than prior to this.
So I guess in the bigger scheme of pictures, as people are looking at the scope of their bills, while we're not recommending, you know, to miss any payments or things of that nature, what is going to give them the least amount of impact on their credit in the mortgage atmosphere, in the bigger score picture, because we all know credit is so hard to repair.
Yeah.
And so what are your thoughts?
Yeah. So, one thing, so here's some tips. I'll give you some tips on what to do. So like I said, do your best to try not to have anything go late. Call your creditors, work out some sort of arrangement, with them. Any federal loans are required to do an arrangement. So if it's a federal home loan or a school loan, they are required to do an accommodation, or like I said, like give you a deal, where it's forbearance or some sort of arrangement. The other creditors, from my understanding, are willing to make the deal, but they're not required to. So like credit cards, your car loan company, mm-hmm. You'd be surprised. We actually we contacted our Comcast internet, and they were willing to push out our payment for our office for 30 days because we're not able to be into our office building right now. So that's one thing you would do. And then the second thing is try not to stress about it. Like I said, you have 30 days before you're actually marked late, before you have that delinquency on your credit report. Mm-hmm. You want to keep an eye on your credit card balances. If you're struggling financially, this is obviously going to be tough to do. But as you max out your credit cards, your score will drop. One maxed out credit card can drop a score by up to 40 points. Now, good news about that, our credit scores don't have a memory. So as soon as you pay that card down or pay it off, your score will rebound. Unlike if you have a 30-day late payment. So if you need to use your credit cards for living, by all means, do it. But just be aware that when your cards are maxed out, it will have a negative impact on your credit score.
Okay. And I guess one of the biggest things that I'm seeing, and I just kind of want to put it out there to everybody too, is that even the forbearance agreement, again, to kind of circle back to that, I keep seeing forbearance is not forgiveness. And just to remind everybody that if you go late three payments, they're not forgiving your payments. They're going to ask for a balloon payment. You can ask that they tack it onto the back end of your loan, but then you have late fees and all kinds of other things. So just be aware that it may sound good, it may not be good. So you may want to talk to an expert, Jeff, myself, whomever makes you comfortable in regards to what that will actually look like. Jeff, if one of the questions that I thought of is that if they agreed to accommodate your credit and you go a year from now and you realize that they didn't, what does it look like to get it changed back the right way?
So just like a defense attorney, the more proof you have, the easier it makes your case. So like we said earlier, Jen, if you can try to get something in writing, that's ideal. So ask your creditor for something in writing. If it's an email, if they can mail you something about the accommodation they make. If that doesn't work, I mean, you have a cell phone. If you can record the call, if you get as much documentation as possible, who you talk to, the date, the number you called in on, their extension, their first, last name, badge ID number. And mm-hmm. then with that information, it is much more likely to get information corrected that's incorrect on the credit report.
Yeah, but how long does that really take? Like, don't you have to? I mean, I remember when you guys were helping me, mm-hmm. I had to pull credit records from mm-hmm. many, many years ago and make show proof. And it took mm-hmm. 60 days or it took 90 days. Some things took 6 months. I mean, that's really what we're looking at, right?
And yeah, realistically, it's probably 45 days to 6 months time frame to get it fixed.
Yeah, and I guess that's kind of what I wanted to emphasize is that once it's messed up, it's kind of hard to come back from. So
yep, absolutely.
While you might not have an option, if you have the option, just make that payment so you don't have to have that argument. I think it will save you some heartache down the road.
Yeah.
All right. Any other food for thought you want to share with us, Jeff?
Yeah, for sure. So checking your credit report on a regular basis is something that I definitely recommend doing. There's a lot of sites out there that people have, but one of the more accurate sites or the most accurate site you can get your credit report for free is annualcreditreport.com. Prior to this pandemic, you were only eligible to get one of those credit reports per year. And now I found out actually just earlier this week is that they're allowing you to pull your credit through annualcreditreport.com once a week now for free. It's a soft inquiry, so it doesn't impact your credit at all. And so if you guys are concerned about identity theft, if you're concerned about information on your credit, you can go to annualcreditreport.com, pull your reports there. And then we'd love to offer a free consultation to review any information you have on there and give you advice.
Super. And then, you know, one other thing that you had mentioned before is that a mortgage credit report or is that just a general consumer credit report?
Yeah. So annualcreditreport.com is just going to give you your three credit reports through Equifax, TransUnion, and Experian.
Okay.
Now, if you want to know your real credit score, there's only one website you can actually get your real credit scores. And the website is myfico.com. That's myfico.com. You do have to pay for it there. You can sign up for their monitoring. It's $30 or one-time pull is going to be $60. Doesn't impact your credit score. And you're going to have accurate credit scores and accurate credit report from myfico.com. So if you want to know your score and report, go to myfico.com. If you just want to know, check your credit report, you can go to annualcreditreport.com. And it's absolutely free.
Okay, cool. And I'll make sure to get the rest of those links from you and attach them to this video as well. Well, thanks for being with us, Jeff. I always appreciate your great information. And like I said, I'll make sure to get those links and we can attach them to here as well. If you'd like to give your contact information.
So you guys can go to our website, which is bluewatercredit.com. We've actually just written three blogs that are you can use to actually when you call the creditor what to say. There's also going to be an outline of the changes to the Fair Credit Reporting Act based on the CARES Act. And there's a lot of resources that you can go. So you can get the free resources there. You can schedule a risk-free consultation for us to review your credit and give advice. And Jen, too, like the last time we recorded this, we do have an attorney on staff now. Feel free to check out our blog. And then our number one goal is to provide help, hope, and solutions to anyone struggling with bad credit. And Jen, like before, I wanted to share, if it's okay, the five words that we're kind of emphasizing to those around us.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
I had it on a notepad over here.
So, no worries.
Yeah, so the first word is unity. During this difficult time, we're recommending that we all try to stay unified. Stay unified with your family, stay unified with your coworkers, and obviously your friends. The second word that we're emphasizing is grace. So try to have a little more grace with everyone. Someone told me this, and it's pretty funny. It's like we're all playing tennis with the wrong hand right now. So it's like I'm trying to play tennis with my left hand. You know, we're homeschooling three kids. Stay working from home, obviously. You know, there's so much that's different. So having a little more grace because everyone's going through a challenging time right now.
Mm-hmm.
The third word is safety. You know, make sure that we're doing our best not to put ourselves at risk. And the fourth word, which is probably my favorite, is vision. I think COVID-19 has really limited a lot of people in our ability to see past this and realize that let's start dreaming past this. Let's start thinking about our goals and our future once we get through this. And the fifth word is hope. Realize that it's always darkest right before dawn, and we're going to get through this, and we're going to be stronger on the other side. So thanks so much, Jen, for having me on your call. And yeah, if you guys have questions, feel free to reach out anytime. Office number is 916-315-9190. And yes, we're still open and operating.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, I just showed a bunch of houses yesterday. It's been a long time since I've showed four, which is not really.
Oh, good for you. That's awesome.
In the scheme of things. Anyway, I'm Jennifer Klein Lewis at 916-678-1552. I'll also have more information on my blog at jenklein.com. And, you know, we are seeing the light at the end of the tunnel. There's been some talk about lifting restrictions, and obviously we'll do that carefully and smartly and with integrity. So feel free to reach out to either one of us or whoever you trust to get your questions answered. We're happy to hear from you. Thanks so much and have a great day.